So we'll be continuing with the buffering in DSP processes. Buffering in DSP processes is very important to understand the methodology in which writing into a memory is being done. After a particular value is being calculated, there should be a procedure in which data has to be written into the memory. So this is achieved by means of buffering, that is data being stored in output buffers. So this buffering operation is usually done by means of linear buffering and circular buffering. However, linear buffering is a conventional method of buffering in DSP processes. Let us see how linear buffering is being done. So in order to calculate the output of output Y of N, for example, in a filter which contains 9-tap FIR filter, which requires X of N up to X of N minus 8, that are 9 samples, we need to know all the 9 samples that are required to implement a particular FIR filter. All the values of this particular samples are stored in an array. Each value is corresponds to a particular memory location. And in linear buffering, the pointer is always set to the top of the or beginning of the sample array. So as in this case, currently at the top of the array, we have the oldest sample, which is nothing but X of N minus 8, and all the particular samples are present over here. So in the next consecutive operation, we acquire to fetch the next newest sample X of N. So this X of N has to be fetched over here. In order to obtain this, what happens is all these input samples have to be moved one location below as such, so that we obtain the next newest sample over here. And hence, when we conclude that while performing linear buffering, we perform 9 memory write operations just to acquire one newest sample X of N, which is a disadvantage, right? Because to just get one new sample, we need to perform 9 memory write operation, because every memory location data is being shifted to its new position in order to acquire a new sample of data. So this disadvantage is overcome in circular buffering. So circular buffering helps to implement, it is very efficient in implementing FIR filters. It requires delay lines or buffers of past and current samples. Circular addressing simplifies the manipulation of pointers in accessing the data samples. You can see here that this is a circular buffer at some instant, where X of N here represents the newest sample and X of N minus 8 represents the oldest sample. When implementing a circular buffer, the contents of these samples need not get shifted. Instead, only the place where we have to acquire the newest sample, the data is being written. For example, X of N at memory location 4 is where we need to obtain a newest sample. So this pointer points to the newest sample, and that point alone, a new value of data is being written. Taking it another example, X of N minus 3 at memory location 5 is where we need to obtain the newest sample. Hence, the pointer pointing to X of N minus 3 to memory 5 with the value of 0.975 alone is written, whereas there is no shifting of data in yet other values of the samples. This is called as circular buffering. Here, the memory operation is being performed, or the write operation is performed only once or only one time for fetching a new sample. And hence, circular buffering is very efficient when you try to implement an FIR filter. Thank you.